Wow, that FOV. That FOV. Blimey, that's bad. That is bad. Oh my god. It's because I've already got it set up to a high FOV. So now it's really bad. Oh my god. Oh my god. That is quite the FOV, isn't it? Blimey. Hello, drop. Wow, that's gone. Let's zoom in, shall we? Welcome to the Wherry Lines Steam version, because that's the one I have, thanks to Dovetail. Very nice. We're going to just give this a little try. Yeah, it's because the FOV is already set to 130%, and that's on top of what I've already modified the game with. So now it's like magnifying it ridiculously. Well, right. Yeah, I need to get set up here. Brakes can come off. Forwards. That's it. Are we going? Are we going now? I never managed to read the thing. You must start the locomotives. Before waiting further instructions, please not depart until you receive these instructions. This is a oh dear. I know how to start the engine up. Okay. Come on then. There we go. Starting up. Whoa, that was that's some clag and a half. It's just a case of pushing the Z key, right? Hope so. Open the doors. No, I don't need to open the doors. I'm not at the platform. This isn't the platform. Right. Has this one started up? I've no idea. Let's pop to the cab, shall we? Oh, wow. Yeah, that seems started up. Right. It told me that I was going to receive more instructions, but there we go. Hopefully I'll get them in a minute. Set your FOV to 100. That's not good. That's what I need to do that. So scroll all the way in, then scroll back to 104. I could change it, but I'd have to quit train sim to change it. So I can't do that. All set up now, right? I think so. No idea. I'm hearing the engine do things, so I must be ready to go. In fact, if I put the brakes on, that's it. I throttle her up. Yeah, okay, cool. Just wanted to check that, make sure both engines are running, and they are. So that's good. Right. I just have never changed yet. Well, for most trains, I need to, because the default is 60. But this has been modified. This particular train's been modified, so it gets multiplied. For most other trains, like the ones I've been driving, I need to change it because it's you know, it's different. I was told to please do not depart until you receive these instructions. So I'm not going to depart anywhere at the moment. Apparently, I'm not going anywhere. Just got to sit around, apparently. Oh, this is entertaining. Blimey. Tell you what, AP did some nice work on this cab, though, didn't they? DTG moved the AP carriage sounds. No, they didn't. AP made new sounds for the DTG version, then updated their version. DTG didn't remove anything. Oh, right, everyone's aboard, so you may pull up to signal CO572 in readiness for departure. There we go. What signal is that, by the way? I take it it's the one that's up here. Yeah, we can pull up to the signal. Right. Alright. I've never been on this line, no. Still farming with the class 37. Very good. Very good. Alright. Oh, DTG haven't done anything to this. can hear it. It's got the classic AP flange and everything. I have to scroll in every time I go into the cab now. That's fun. Right. Let's ease on the brakes a bit. Because we have got a red, where we've just got to wait our departure. I'm going to stop at this red. See? I can stop at reds. I can. I'm not totally hopeless when it comes to driving trains. There you go. Now we wait. Probably waiting for another train to pass. No idea. Alright, zoom back in. I need to set it to 104 is the best. That's it. Because it does the least clipping, I think. Alright. So it's my own fault that I've done that. Default is fine. So this is a three-part scenario. I won't do all three parts, because it'll take hours, but... let's do part one, which I believe takes us to... all stops to Great Yarmouth. So there we go. So one thing that AP does with their scenarios that usher in a new level of realism... you know, when you drive a DTG scenario, it's open the doors, close the doors, go. I'm not colourblind, I'm colour deficient, which means I see... well, the shade of green I see will be different to the shade of green you see. Essentially. That's what it boils down to. Listen to that. Zoom in, and zoom out. That's... oh dear. Right. I have to get used to that. Alright, we're on our way. Summon the Millennium Falcon. Punch it, Chewie! Going all the way to Great Yarmouth. Oh, I do like this route. I do like it. 170! Very nice. Might drive the 170 after this on the same route. We'll see. Go via a different way, maybe. That's it. Let's just brake for the 15, hopefully, or make it down in time. Yeah, lovely. See, look at that. That is beautiful. There's no other way of putting it, really. You think Great Yarmouth should change their name to Great Mole Man? I think some people would have something to say about that, to be perfectly honest. But thank you nonetheless. Alright. And zoom hype. Zoom back out, tiny little increments. There we go. Speed limit goes up to 60 and is the limit. I believe this entire line is 60, so that's fun. Oh, that classic bell. Gotta love it. 25. Passenger view. Full throttle. That's such a good sound. So good. So good indeed. Yes. This is classic action right here. Oh, 170. Very nice. Alright, so, yeah. Essentially what this scenario is we're pretending to do a passenger service. Really. This is what it is. We're pretending to do a passenger service. We're testing. Before these trains actually enter service. It's strange. Yep, 60 miles an hour thereabouts. Just coast along now. Brundle Gardens, 3.5 miles. Yeah, well, Dilbot, that's the that's the experience, really, isn't it? That's why people do it. You know. Don't know if my main line would visit the Wherry Lines. Not entirely sure. We'll see. Trouble is, all the mainline stuff. I've changed my logo, which means it's all out of date. Lol. Right. Yeah, well, you know, I'm not here. I'm not, you know, just, if it's not busy, it doesn't bother me at all. If anything, it means I'll drive easier, so it'd be easier for me to drive because I won't have to worry about anything. So, you know, whatever. Doesn't matter how many people are watching, in my opinion. The numbers mean nothing. But I am grateful you're here, so you know. If you are here, I'm grateful. Yay. You get what I'm saying, I'm just not very good at saying it. 20 limit. That's to go over the bridge. There's a bridge. We are playing Train Simulator. We're on the Wherry Line, driving the 37. Power down. Everyone's... Right. Good old AWS. Warning me for the 20. I'm already braking for it. We'll be down in time. It's literally just a speed limit for the locomotives only. Multiple unit wouldn't have this problem. Just got to slow down because we're a loco. To go over a bridge. That's fun. Look at that. The detail on this route is absolutely incredible. AP did, you know, pull out all the stops for this one, and it really shows. I'm just sad that they said they're only going to ever do this route. They're not going to really look at doing any more. The amount of detail they could put into routes is incredible. Just look at that. There is a plan to make an old steam locomotive from just a blueprint. Heard it somewhere. Might be true, you never know. I mean, we sort of did that here. We built Tornado, which is an LNER Peppercorn A1 steam locomotive. We built that, started building it in 1990s and finished it in like 2007-2008. Are we ready for this? Are we ready? Gardens is approaching. What I love about this route is the stations are so rural. And what is it? Is it what's the station? Is it Burnie Arms? One of the least used stations in the country. This is a classic, beautiful one. It's not pitiful, it's amazing. That's just my opinion anyway. I won't be playing, obviously. I don't like buses, so it'd be kind of pointless. I need to brake quite substantially now. That's it. Probably not I'm Crazy Dan, at least not at this stage, not at the moment, but thank you anyway. Any arms? That's it, yeah. You are the god of hellfire. Fair enough. Right. There we go. Welcome to Brundle Gardens. Looks like farm sim. It is quite rural in that regard. We are in Norfolk, so right near the Broads. This is going to be an interesting stop. Hey, the breast is going to go off. There we go. I don't, Ronnie, and I don't want him right now. If that's, you know, if that's okay. Well, that's close enough, right? I mean, not all the doors are going to open anyway. Train's platform barely long enough. Could passengers in any coach apart from the middle one? There's no passengers on board, but you know, technically. Right. That's it. Oh, that's close enough anyway. They do have classic signalling. They do indeed. Hello, Trucker Joe. Welcome to the stream. Yellow up there. That's one of those signals that just displays yellow and green, isn't it? I think so. That's an advanced signal. It's not on the HUD, so it's not an actual signal. That's fun. Let's go. Does. Next stop is Brundle, which isn't far away at all. Although the next signal I think is red until you approach it, so I will approach with caution. I think I have to remember how that signal works. It's like an on-site sort of thing, so it'll be red until we get near it. Yeah, I'm crazy, Dan. What these are is, yeah, these coaches were modelled for the Wherry Lines, and then AP did loads of liveries to make the pack. They're the same coaches essentially, but these ones are included in the Wherry Lines route if you buy it anywhere. So there you go. Now I believe, yeah, that signal's red until we get near it. I think that's how it works. Or failing that, I'm about to have another signal failure problem. There we go. Yeah, it goes up just as you get near it. That's how that signal works, thankfully. Right. Why do I like steam trains so much? Because they're beautiful. They're historic. They're nostalgic. You know, that's the way it is. You know, it's a romantic era of the steam trains. They all have a soul. In my opinion, the only train to have a soul, a modern train, in quotes, like that, is the APT. Because APT is just beautiful in its own right. Right. Yeah, so this is the Wherry Lines. You can buy it on... If you buy it on from the Armstrong Powerhouse website, you need a bunch of... You need to own several other routes for it to work. If you buy it from... if you buy it on Steam, which is essentially identical, you get all the assets included. The only difference is the locos aren't branded, because DRS don't want to work with Dovetail. Nice. Doors. Whoa, hello. Doors. There we go. Stick back over this side. How are the signals looking, actually? That is definitely not in my favour. Beautiful, isn't it? There's a class 185 being made by Master Key Simulations. 707's probably way too brand new for anyone to try and make it at the moment, considering the fact that only a couple of drivers have only just been trained on them. So, you know, I doubt that will happen just yet. I got that bang on. Wow, look at that. Absolutely bang on. That's beautiful. Well done me. That's screenshot worthy, that is. Ooh, did you hear that? That was the sound of the signal. The signals make sounds. Because that 170's pulled in. We can now depart when we need to. Right. Norwich Fire Ackle, if that's how you say it. Tucker Joe, if you, they haven't shown it off yet, but if you go to Master Key Simulations' Facebook page, you can see a render of it, which shows that they've at least modelled one. But they're making the Class 460 first. Time for us to go. We've just repainted the first 170's GA red and white. Interesting. I wonder how that looks. Probably, well, as you'd expect, really. Alright. I'm speeding, but you know. Who cares? I'm too busy reading the chat. Welcome back, Cameron's Gaming. Like, yeah, I kind of like old trains. It depends, really. Some trains are better than others. But, you know, I do like stuff like the 37 and like stuff like that, you know, it's all good. It's all good. CTC Trains and Yeses will be up on YouTube, so you can watch that whenever you want to. Let's full throttle it. Wonderful. Truly wonderful. So, well, Lingwood, Ackle, and Great Yarmouth. Hello Neil, welcome to the stream. Facebook is Master Key Simulations. That's where you'll find it. That's the news and stuff like that. They don't post that often, like once a week maybe, but the stuff they're making looks fantastic. So definitely keep an eye out. There's Lingwood, top of the hill. Yes, good old Wherry Lines. Thought I'd give it a little jaunt. Frame rate, wow. In my time zone, it is currently 10 to 2 in the afternoon. Yes. Clear it. There's the AWS going off. Cautionary signal. No problem. Start braking. And another one. There we go. That's it. Sounds so good, the track joint sounds as well. It's a sound steadily disappearing from the country, it really is. As track gets refurbished, it gets replaced by continuously welded rail, whatever it's called, and classic track join sounds disappear, sadly. Right. Just approaching Lingwood. Near more or less on time, which is good. Single track, I don't know which side the platform's going to be on. Can't really tell from here. This route is set last year, believe it or not. This year, last year. We set last year, or maybe slightly before then. This is a modern day route. It's just, it's sort of stuck in time because it's got old signals and... Ah, it's this side. It's got old signals and old locomotives and stuff, so... It's, yeah... It's an interesting route, definitely. That's it. And bring it to a stop there. And doors. Let the no passengers off. This is Lingwood. There you go, look at that. Don't get on. This is a test service. Silly. If it's not UK light chips, I probably don't have it installed, so probably not. If you're talking about train sim, that is. Yep, LED lights. There you go. LED markers, anyway. The main beam still. Bulb by the looks of it. But yeah, it's two locomotives and only three coaches. It can accelerate very quickly. That's the way it is. These are very, you know, it's quite, quite powerful locomotives, really. Designed to haul a lot more than just a few coaches at a time, so they can accelerate really quickly. It's the scenes you can get on this route that just makes it absolutely, you know, amazing. Like this. No, the other route. The route via Redam is very nice as well. FOV, let's go back out here. That's a better option. Right. Oh, downhill. It's going to be fun. Yes, I saw that photo as well, Leo. Definitely interesting, to say the least. Power down. Listen to those classic running sounds. For the coaches there, it's beautiful. Not entirely sure, light chips, how much it has, really. You'd have to look it up, actually. We could probably find out somewhere. There should be a board. That tells us, gives us info. Maybe not. Sometimes there is. There's usually like a board that tells you, but apparently there isn't on this one. Maybe there is over here. Nope, no idea. Speed limit of 50 at the bottom of this hill. It's going to be fun. And the station, so... Oh, good old laggy Norfolk. There we go, right. It's a shame, really, that Traction Depot's workshop extension to Norwich never actually stayed and, you know, was fixed on workshop. Because they extended the Great Eastern Main Line from Ipswich to Norwich, but it disappeared due to a number of problems. And that was probably, what, a year ago now? And it never came back. It's sad, really. This is quite an old locomotive. The first one started to appear well. I don't know. I'm not that well versed on the history of these things. I just know that they're awesome. No idea, Trucker Joe. Absolutely no idea. I don't really plan that far ahead. This gradient's really messing with my braking. Shortly arriving at Ackle. 1960, there you go. Yeah, but the Pendolino, it can run, because it can run under, you know, it can run across the entire country, so the 37s are seen anywhere, pretty much, so. And at Norwich, where we started off, there were overhead wires. Come on, the gradient really messing with my braking here. Oh, blimey. Wow! 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 That did not want to stop. That really didn't want to stop. Oh, just those passengers can get off today. There's no one getting off anyway. It's a test service, apparently. I think pretty much every train has the overhead warning. Even the 465s do. It's just there. That's the same. That's what the orange stripe is as well. Don't go above that with anything, you know, metal essentially. No, there's not Cameron's Gaming. No, there's not. Bit of an overshoot, but you know. Yeah, it is modern. They would have put new lights in it, but it's still the old signalling system. Still the old semaphores. But other than that, yeah, they would have put new lights in, because otherwise you aren't see them properly. So, let's go. I'm going to stick around and watch the signal drop. Lovely. The animation they put into that, the work they did. Whoa! FOV again. That's better. Right, yeah, the work they put into the semaphores is amazing. I love them. Alright, Great Yarmouth, 7 miles. There we go. I'm going to drive a class 50 in April. That's, wow, that's nice. Go. Proper flatlands now. Look at this. You can see for miles. FOV over 9,000. Yes. I'm driving a class 37 on the Wherry Lines, and you've missed various forms of banter. So there we go. Trucker Joe, you read the readme that comes with the reskin. That's pretty much the only thing I can say, because it can be different. Oh, wow. I was reading the chat, and now the emergency brakes have gone off. GG. GG. This is what the passengers would do, isn't it? Just hang their head in shame. I can't do anything against this now. I have to wait till we stop. Of course I got an ADRS warning the second I looked at the chat. I actually physically looked over instead of just glancing. Off the brakes. Forwards. Full throttle. Let's go again. Oh, wow. Thanks. Thanks for the fail one. That's just great. Love it. Thanks. Oh dear. Got the fail command. Head to set around. Right, back up to 60. Speed. Lol, floating grass fail. Sit. I do Trucker Joe, I do have that reskin. I tried driving it in the last stream, but it didn't go very well. Listen to that track join. Seriously, the screenshot potential here is incredible. Because if we just pull way, but whoa, I'm under the ground. That wasn't meant to happen. That's the sort of screenshot I like to take. There you go. You see, look at that. You just pull right out. The Class 387 reskin is made by Super Alps. You can get it from his website. So there you go. See, look at that. That is so cool. This route is so good for stuff like this. So there are track joints in a few places around me as well. I know Strood's got some, but given they're rebuilding the station, I reckon they'll be gone by the end of the year. Yeah, so that's a shame. Right. Here we go, 60. Keep an eye out for AWS. Trucker Joe, just search for Super Alps. You'll find it on his website. It does look good, doesn't it? It's absolutely incredible. I love this route. I bought it the second it came out, even though it was expensive, but you know. And now I have this one. So the fact that DoveDog gave me this one, the Steam version, is kind of redundant, but you know. Now we've got no track joins. If there were actual windmill things on this, yes, windmill things is a technical term. I mean, if only, right? If only this actually still had its stuff. This just recreates Thomas the Tank Engine. Aren't you preparing? Because train sim stuff isn't designed to be reskinned. It's licensed products, you know. So like officially licensed by Southeastern or stuff like that. But so it's not designed to be reskinned. It's not actively supported, so it's not easy for some in some cases. That's so Thomas the Tank Engine. I love it. You know, people always say, why has this train got such bad mapping when it comes to... It's not designed to be reskinned. You're the one trying to modify the game when it's not supposed to be. So, you know, it's not designed to be reskinned. So that's the whole, you know. Oh, dear. That's just what it is, really. Moo! Over 3 miles to go until Great Yarmouth. Moon Man. Oh, wow. Can you make jointed noises? I can do them for Rochester Bridge. That's about it. Because I know that because that's the speed the trains go over. So there you go. On the Wherry Lines. Wherry Lines, eh? I don't have it installed at the moment, I don't think. Not the route. I've got obviously the route's installed. I don't have that particular locomotive installed. What are the game to use? Oh, that would be cool. I tell you what, the PBL braking system is one of my favourites. You have so much control. I love it. Thomas the Banter engine. You can literally see from my... That's the thing about like DGG routes. The scenery ends like a few feet from the tracks. This, I can see literally for miles. I absolutely love it. It's light on the other side. It's even more gorgeous scenery. We're winning. We are winning. Deal with it. Deal with it. Light chips, only some steam trains actually do that. Ones that are made by companies like Victuworks and stuff, you know, they tend to have proper realistic slip, but you know, the older ones tend to not. It's 50, slow down for the 50. We're nearly at Great Yarmouth. I've enjoyed this. I have to stop. I can't spad Great Yarmouth. No. I can. You know what? That's a good plan. I will adhere to that as best I can. Wow, frame rate. Loading up Great Yarmouth's fun. Yeah, the K1's wheel slip's good. What else do it? Does the 14XX do it? I think it might do. I know that the dock tank does. Dock tank's got fantastic slippage. Alright, start braking for that 15. That's one thing that does, I mean, train sim, obviously the lag spikes, is because it's loading in tiles. Not the only thing that will fix that is putting train sim on an SSD. Because it's 32-bit, it just can't load in the entire route in one go. I reckon if it was 64-bit, it could load the entire route, and then it would never do that. And you get 60fps loveliness, but alas, it's a game that's about 10 years old. Right, here we go. 15 limit for the final bit. An old signal box up there, it's very nice. It's sad how many signal boxes get demolished. I'm glad there's a few around that are, like, you know, grade 2 listed and stuff like that, but so many get demolished. Banbury North is going to be, you know, worst one. Mod fail. What'd you do? I'm speeding because I was looking at the chat. Over we go. Yeah, TS World 64-bit, so routes should load quicker, and they shouldn't lag spike. Should be good. Shouldn't, in theory, if it's all optimised properly. I mean, people complain that the beta wasn't optimised, but they clearly don't understand what the point of a beta is. Ah, fair enough, I'm crazy then. Yeah, the whole point of a beta is, it's buggy, get the community to tell you that it's buggy and what's buggy, and then you fix it for release. Very nicely detailed route, this. I do love it. I want the DRS reskins for the 68 to be fixed, because they're still broken. I want them to be fixed so I can, you know, do the West Anglia replacement service. That'd be cool. Get a bit of 68 thrashing along the Wherry Lines. But the reskins are still broken, as far as I'm aware. Oh, I'm going to stop it there. It. We'll stop it there. Just because of the points here. That's just the way I like to do it if there's points. Could you imagine the loco would come off, go this way, and then... So. There you go. I think, Leo, I think it'll only have sound patch grade on release, and there'll be other routes in the future. Because obviously it's the first route they've ever made for Trains in Wild, so... Unlike with British routes, and in Train Sim at the moment, all the assets are already there, all the houses, trees, it's all there, signalling's already there, but if you've got to build everything from scratch, I imagine doing one thing at a time. So, yeah, it will only have sand patch grade on release. That's as far as the coming soon page says anyway. And we would have seen other stuff by now, because it's only a few weeks away from release. It's certainly quick off the mark, isn't it? Yeah. I won't be doing part two for now, but that was a nice run across the Wherry Lines. That was very nice indeed. I enjoyed that. So, yay for the Wherry Lines and stuff.